I'm Jamie Laux with Innovative Sugarworks, and today I will be demonstrating how to assemble the sugar structure four-legged running. So you start by attaching your base firmly to your board. Be sure to use the three screws that come with your set and attach it very firmly to your board. And then you begin assembling one of the back legs. So you're going to start with a 4-inch rod, and you're going to thread it into your base just until it stops and you're good. And then you're going to take a 30-degree elbow coupler. And you're going to notice inside of these couplers, there are small rubber parts. Those are supposed to be there. Do not try to remove them. These rubber parts are intended to help keep it tight when you twist it together, and to help ensure that if you want to change the angle of what you're working with, when you untwist it, it still stays tight and secure. So attach your 30-degree coupler to your 4-inch rod, and you're going to actually want this to be angled towards the front, towards the head, the shoulders, because that is the way that the leg is going to bend. And next you're going to attach a 3-inch rod. And if you see, by tightening this by hand, I was not able to get it completely pointing forward to the head. But now that I've attached a 3-inch rod, I can use this for leverage. And I can continue twisting until it faces forward. And you can use that at any point while building your structure. So now you want to take a 90-degree coupler. And this 90-degree coupler will attach to the 3-inch rod. Lefty-loosey, righty-tighty. Twist it on, and you want this to be pointed the direction of the other hind leg. All right, so now that you've got that on there, you're gonna take a 1.5-inch rod, and you will attach it to the 90-degree coupler. Tighten it on by hand. And now you're going to take something called a corner coupler. There is a flat bottom, and then there is a joint that comes out the top. And you're going to want the joint coming out the top, and then the open joint on the side going towards the head. And then these ones are going to be for the two legs. So you're going to attach one of the leg ones to your 1.5-inch rod. Being sure to end with one joint facing up and one joint facing towards the head. And that finishes your first leg. Now we're going to move on to step B, the right leg, or left leg, whatever direction you're going with. I think this is now my left leg with where I'm going. So you're going to attach a 1.5-inch rod to the other side of your corner coupler, directly across from your first leg. And then you need a 90-degree elbow for the other hip. And you want this one to point directly downward. This kind of twisted, but you can make your adjustments as you go along. So point it downward. And now we're going to attach a 3-inch rod to your 90-degree coupler. And now we need another 90-degree coupler. And you're going to twist this on to your 3-inch rod and twist it until it is facing forward towards the head. Get it going. Let's go. Am I twisting the wrong way? I am. Yep. All right, that's better. Okay, so have an opening towards the head. Now we will attach a 2-inch rod for the next part of the leg. And then we have a 45-degree coupler. And I should note that all of these couplers have etched on them what angle they are. So this one says 45. Attach a 45 degree to the 2-inch rod, and you want this one to be facing downward, that direction. And now you attach a 1-inch rod. And now you have finished both hind legs. From this point, you want to attach the tail. So the tail begins with a 1-inch rod to the top of your corner coupler. And now we're going to add a 30-degree coupler, and we're going to point that backwards away from the head. And then finally, attach a 2-inch rod. And that is the rear of the assembly completely done. Now we're going to move on to the torso, and that is step D. The torso begins with a 4-inch rod connected to the last opening on your corner coupler. And now there is one more corner coupler, and you're going to have it positioned the same way, facing up, but facing backwards towards the bottom. So attach that to the other end of your 4-inch rod or torso. Be sure that it is facing upward to go towards the neck and facing away from you and towards you for the front legs. And that completes the torso. Now moving on to step E. Step E is your first front leg, and you're going to begin with a 1-inch rod. So 1-inch rod into one side of your corner coupler. And now we're going to use... Even I need to read the instructions sometimes. We're going to be using a 90-degree elbow. And attach that to our 1-inch rod. And this one can actually face forward a little bit because that's going to be one of the running legs. Next, we're going to attach a 3-inch rod. Am I twisting the right direction? I think I am. It's hard to do left-handed sometimes. There. Let's adjust it. Work with my right hand. Much easier. And then we can bend it back to where we were pretty easily. And next, we're going to go with a 60-degree coupler. The 60-degree attaches to the end of your 3-inch rod. And you want to point it downward. Next, we have a 2-inch rod connect to your 60-degree coupler. And for a little bend at the bottom of the foot, I'm going to go with a 45-degree coupler pointed backwards towards the hind legs, and a tiny little 1-inch rod. And that completes the first front leg. And next, we will do the other front leg, starting with another small 1-inch rod. Turn so you can see it a little bit better. And next, we want a 90-degree coupler. And you also want this one to be pointed forward a little bit. And plenty of adjustments can be made after you've got all your pieces put together. Gonna go with a 3-inch rod. Might have to turn this so I can see it a little bit better. Oops. There we go. Get that one in. Okay, and we're gonna go with a 45-degree coupler attached to your 3-inch rod. Next, a 2-inch rod. another 45 degree. And this one will also be pointed back towards the hind legs because it's another bend in the foot. And a tiny little 1-inch rod. Sometimes it takes just a little. There we go. Perfect. Now we have all four legs. Lastly is the neck. So the neck starts with a 3-inch rod, which goes into the last opening of your corner coupler. Just straight up. And then we're going to go with a 30-degree elbow. 30-degree elbow coupler. And you're going to want to face this one forward. And then you need a 5-inch rod into your 30-degree coupler. We have a 45-degree elbow. And last but not least, a 2-inch rod to complete your four-legged running armature. All right, and from this point, this is where you can go through and maybe disassemble to tighten up some things that you need. You can use these rods that you've put in to create extra leverage if you need something to be extra tight. Extra leverage. You can change the position if you want legs more up in the air, if you want this guy really getting up in the air. And there you have it. That's four-legged running standing armature from Shirtworks. Bye.